Is your engine trying to tell you something? There's usually a lot of signs or a lot of warnings that your engine is about to die, that it's about to give up the ghost. Spotting these signs early on can be the difference between having the inconvenience of a breakdown or having an engine that needs to be replaced rather than one that can just be repaired with a simple part or a little bit of maintenance can bring that engine back up and restore its overall reliability and its efficiency. So what are some of the things that we need to be looking out for when it comes to our engine, where the engine is just trying to tell us there's a problem looming that we need to be aware of? So the first thing is knocking or tapping sounds. So if the engine is making any weird noises, whether it's a knocking sound, a grinding noise, a tapping sound, maybe it happens when we accelerate, when we decelerate, when we go around a corner, all of these little things can build up a picture that there is something going wrong inside the engine. So we need to be aware of the baseline on our engine. What noises does it typically usually make? And anything new should be investigated. That could well be one of those early signs that the engine is about to fail on us or die on us. The next thing we need to look out for is excessive smoke coming from the exhaust. So if the engine is smoking, it's not burning the fuel efficiently, there's some problem going on. It could just be a sensor. It could be a fuel injector problem. There's a lot of causes for excessive smoke coming out of the exhaust, but that is a major symptom that there is something wrong with the engine. And this can very quickly escalate into very expensive problems, particularly if you have a particulate filter, which most modern cars now do, especially here in Europe. So as you're driving the car, have you noticed it's hard to accelerate, it's being hesitant, it's not running as smoothly or as sweetly as it once did? These can all be signs that there is a looming problem in the engine and they should be investigated quickly. Just generally, if the car feels less powerful than it did when you first got it, that can be a sign that there is something seriously going wrong inside the engine that needs to be addressed. So some of the smells to look out for is metallic smells, overheating smells, burning smells, rubber smells, anything that's untoward that can indicate that there is something going wrong inside the engine or the engine bay, and that can lead to bigger problems or more expensive repair bills if not addressed. So don't ignore these problems when they first happen. Have you had warning lights come up on the dashboard? The check engine light, has that flashed up? Is it flickering on and off periodically, or has it stayed illuminated? These warning signs are important and we certainly shouldn't ignore those as a driver. Maybe you've noticed the fuel economy has dropped. So a drop in fuel economy can be down to any number of things. Even having insufficient pressure in the tyres can cost you about 10% of your fuel economy. But any drop in your fuel economy from standard should be investigated, and that can indicate that there is a problem there that needs to be addressed at some point in the near future. Is the engine less smooth? Is it starting to shake or vibrate more than it did when you first got it? Some engines are very, very smooth when they come out of the factory. Other engines rattle a lot. They're quite agricultural in the way that they work. So whatever engine you've got, learn to recognize the normal. And if you go outside of the normal and it starts misbehaving, it's rattling more or vibrating more, that can indicate that you've got a problem that needs to be addressed. Keep an eye on the oil. If the oil level is dropping, if the oil looks very black and thick, if it's burning oil, or if the oil light, the oil pressure light, keeps coming on, and maybe even if it goes off, but if it's been on, that's an indicator that there is some sort of problem there. And oil, really, it's the lifeblood of the engine. It's protecting all the metal on metal wear that's going on in the engine. So if there's a problem with the oil pump, the oil circulation system, that can have a detrimental effect on the engine if that's not addressed early on. If you've noticed that the engine has trouble starting, it takes longer to start, or it doesn't start on cold mornings, or when the engine's warm, it doesn't start. These can all indicate that there is some sort of problem looming inside the engine that should be looked out for. It could just be down to wear and tear on the internal components, or it could be a sign that something is starting to malfunction and you've got that knock-on effect. So I hope this video has been useful to you. If you've got any of these symptoms, I've probably done another video that goes into those symptoms more specifically, and it'll help you to diagnose the problem. Get yourself an OBD2 code reader, because plugging that into the OBD2 port and downloading any error codes or diagnostic trouble codes will go a long way to identifying the potential causes of these problems that really have just been flagged up so far as a symptom. You've not got anything specific to work on. And that really is a good indicator as to where we should go to start addressing the problem. So please boot the like button if you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments if you've got any other suggestions for videos that I should do in the future, or any comments on this video, points that maybe I've missed that can indicate that the engine is about to die on you. And I've lined this video up for you in this playlist that you should find really interesting. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. We'd love you to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in these next videos.